These final days before the election are tense times. Today's toxic politics are hurtful and heartbreaking for many of us. I think we all need a hope vaccine, an injection of kindness, curiosity, and understanding for those who see the world differently than we do. I'm Richard Davies, and our guests today are liberal Dorsey Cartwright and conservative Roger Haynes, blue and red citizens and voters who will sit together outside a polling place in Austin, Texas, on Election Day.
We're going to the polls across the country, and we're going to show people that even though elections can be contentious, they don't have to be. We can actually show up together and show, hey, we can still get along. And we really want to show a simple way to bridge that divide, because there's so much rancor.
So this is really, for me, kind of an interesting, possibly fun, probably safe way of getting out on the street and having our signs and doing our best to hand out cards, you know, but I'm out there.
Our show is about fixes.
Yeah, how to make the world a better place.
How do we fix it?
How do we fix it?
Our next few podcasts will cover the Braver Angels Election Day Initiative. And we're doing these shows right alongside our friends at A Braver Way, a wonderful podcast hosted by Monty Guzman. We'll both be reporting on something that's never been tried before, something that runs completely counter to our recent years of political climate change, the hurricane of hate, resentment, and disdain that far too many on the right and left feel for the other side. So how do we fix it? Well, here's a start. On Election Day, red and blue volunteers will sit together outside polling sites across America, and we're going to hear from two of them. Roger Haynes' politics lean red. He's a retired chief master sergeant with 23 years of active military service. Roger is passionate about the First and Second Amendments. Dorsey Cartwright is a blue. She's a retired marriage and family therapist and now an active member of No Labels and its mission to depolarize Congress. On Election Day in Austin, Roger's going to wear his red Braver Angels baseball hat alongside Dorsey Cartwright, who will have on a blue hat. Now, our interview. Roger Haynes and Dorsey Cartwright, welcome to How Do We Fix It?
Thank you.
Thank you, Richard. Great to be here. Good to see you, Dorsey.
That's a friendly way to begin. Let me start by asking both of you, first Dorsey, why you decided to get involved with this Election Day initiative.
You know, I've been thinking about that, Richard, kind of preparing for, you know, our time together. And I have a little bit of a story. Is that okay?
That's great. We love stories here.
Good. Well, thinking about it, I realized, you know, I first heard about Braver Angels not too long after the 2016 election.
And Dorsey says that this was soon after Braver Angels was founded. She read about the new movement in an article written by Braver Angels co-founder Bill Dougherty.
When I read it, I thought, gee, I'd like to experience that. You know, he talked about the Red Blue workshop and everything. I thought I'd like to do that. But you know how life gets busy. And so I just kind of went along, and I had been involved with No Labels.
No Labels is an organization that actively supports bipartisanship in Congress, and it brings together House and Senate members from both parties. Dorsey watched one of their videos in 2020 when a Republican senator was asked a question.
I think one of the No Labels members had said something about, why is there so much fighting and name-calling and everything in the House? You need to be more civil. And he said, you know, that's very true. We really do. And if the public would be more civil with one another, you would see that reflected in the houses. I mean, that's a simple thing, but it just went through me. And then right after that came this announcement about this Braver Angels workshop being held online. And so, you know, I snapped it up. It was around the issue of climate change. And it was so remarkable because I'm the blue one in this pair. But I got to hear the point of view from people who resist or kind of fight against some of the climate change measures. I mean, it's like I shifted. I had a new understanding. I had a new perspective. I kind of thought if I was in his shoes, I'd probably be kind of thinking along the same lines. And so, so I got involved with Braver Angels. You know, I became a moderator and I've been involved with different things. But this particular one, this election day, you know, this is new. Braver Angels hadn't done this before. It's an experiment.
Let me bring in Roger before we unpack what the Election Day initiative is for both of you. And because that was a pretty good origin story, Roger. How do you beat that? What's your story?
Going second is really difficult. How do you follow that?
Roger told us he first came to Braver Angels several years ago during the pandemic and attended Red Blue workshops and other events in Texas.
Anyways, I started attending some of the Alliance meetings and enjoyed it, and then gradually fell away, got spread too thin, and you know, I'm retired Air Force now, you know, and I lean more conservative in some areas. I found that over time, I probably am a little bit more purple than red. I really felt like getting back involved with Braver Angels was where I needed to be. From my skills as a military senior leader, as a you know enlisted guy, being a recruiter, I felt like maybe my skills could be used. And so I really wanted to do something, and I got back involved and met Dorsey at one of the Alliance meetings recently we had, and she told me about this event. I'm like, man, this is perfect. Let's put ourselves out there. Let's get to the polls. Let's do this.
So you're both going to be at the polls together on Election Day, one red, one blue. Tell us more, Roger.
Braver Angels is sending reds and blues in pairs, people that lean more to the, you know, Democratic side, the more liberal side, the people that lean more towards the, you know, conservative or Republican side. We're going to the polls across the country, and we're going to show people that even though elections can be contentious, they don't have to be. We can actually show up together and show, hey, we can still get along. And we really want to show a simple way to bridge that divide, because there's so much rancor. I've been doing campaigning for, you know, the red side, and, you know, I'm on social media a lot, and I just felt like, man, I want to do more campaigning for Braver Angels, just because no matter who wins, someone loses. And in politics, this is my thoughts. You know, we used to kind of talk about breaking glass in the military. Someone has to clean it up, and it's going to be us, all of us, reds, blues, others, after the election. And so we really do need to do something to slow down the anger, the rancor, and really get back to having conversations. In 3 weeks, I've had more conversations with people that are far from being similar to my leanings. And it's great. At the end of the call or the Zoom or the one-on-one, you're like, man, I'm so glad I met you. You know, there's no anger. There's no meme creating that's, you know, tearing somebody's head off or whatever. Does that make sense?
It makes a lot of sense to me. I'm sure it does to you too, Richard, having heard you. I want to do a little bigger picture and in this sense. Braver Angels has created what they're calling American Hope. And it's got three parts to it. One part is they've created a really powerful petition to the party leaders that we can sign, challenging our party leaders to reduce this toxic polarization. And then another one is the membership voted on what seemed to be a key issue for Americans, and they selected immigration. So people are leading and participating in common ground workshops on immigration, very similar to the one you had on your other podcast about, you know, trustworthy elections. This third one is actually on election day. I was drawn to this one because, to me, one of my painful places around 2020 was the fact that, from my perspective, our elections were the most secure that we've had. Remarkable job, given we were in the middle of a pandemic, and that all our poll workers, everybody deserves such kudos. And pretty much the opposite happened in a very severe way.
It happened. So, the opposite happened in that there was a tremendous amount of upset.
Workers being accused, and it was just heartbreaking to me. And so to have the opportunity to, on election day, to be there with someone from the other side as a symbol of, hey, we're in this together and we're going to work together. We're not going to get into all this other stuff. And it's just another part of what the Braver Angels calls holding America together.
Where are you going to do this? Are you going to sit behind a table outside a polling station? Where?
Listen, Roger has been so great. He is such a go-getter. He talked to people until he found a place in Austin that has a diversity of voters. It's a church, and you have to be 100 yards away from, you know, the polling place. And we'll probably be a mixture of standing together and sitting together. But we also have, we're going to have two signs. One of them says something about, one of us is red, one of us is blue, but we're Americans through and through, which on one hand is kind of hokey, but it's like a chant. And then we're going to have these cards that Braver Angels has created.
And those cards will include a QR code with an invitation to a nationwide Zoom call to be held by Braver Angels on election night. You can find out more and sign up to be part of the Braver Angels Election Initiative at the Braver Angels website, which is braverangels.org/election day. Another way to learn more is to listen to A Braver Way, a podcast about how all of us individually can work to depolarize America. You'll hear many moving and deeply personal stories. Now back to How Do We Fix It, our interview with Dorsey and Roger. They'll both be at a polling place in Austin, Texas on election day. Dorsey's politics are blue, Roger's are red, and he's excited about this initiative on election day.
We're getting our signs made. We've got a location, which is key. Obviously, we have our Braver Angels t-shirts and hats. It's going great. You know, I just started posting on social media about it. You know, really trying to get people to be curious. At this point in our times, I think it's very interesting to the average American to even maybe see a Harris and a Trump supporter, or even in the same area. So I'm really excited about it. I'm hopeful. You know, hope is not a strategy, but it gives us a little bit of that encouragement about the future. And that's really, you know, why this is so important. But what's really cool about it is that we're putting ourselves out there. We're growing, right, as community. And we're actually, you know, getting the word out about Braver Angels. We're taking that risk. And sometimes you have to take a little bit of a risk to get that reward. And ultimately, we do want to show that we can bridge that divide and, depolarize one person at a time. I love this because I need to be around people that don't agree with me. I need to understand them. And it's really important to show that this is possible to other people. It gives people that courage to take that first step. We need to get out of that echo chamber and, go meet some people that are, you know, different. They're our neighbors, believe it or not. They're right next door. But we build fences and we don't ever go past our own fence.
Dorsey, do you feel the same way? Do you feel that you need to hang out with people who see the world differently than you do?
Yes, in this way, Richard. To hang out with people that are safe to discuss our differences. That's what I've appreciated about, be it Braver Angels, No Labels. There's like a value in, I know that we see things differently and we might even get into an argument about it, but it's being done in good faith. You see, that helps me. It helps me build my innards because I can get triggered so easily. I have such strong feelings. And also, I learn. I change inside. Like Roger, I'm really becoming much more purple than blue because, you know, I broaden my horizons. I want to say one other thing, Richard, because I was just listening to your Fix It podcast with Jesse and Luke at the Republican convention. And right at the end of it, Jesse said something that just hit home with me. She said she's been a keyboard warrior. And I have been a keyboard warrior, but it's time to get out. You have to get out on the streets. You've got to be a citizen activist. You've got to get out on the street. And so this is really, for me, kind of an interesting, possibly fun, probably safe way of getting out on the street and having our signs and doing our best to hand out cards, you know, but I'm out there.
I find among my friends who are red-leaning and conservative, I'm blue-leaning and kind of liberal, although edging towards purple like you guys, that I meet a lot more red friends who go, some of my best friends are liberals. I'm around liberals all the time. I don't hear that as much among blues. And I just wondered, I'm just going to throw that out there for one of you to pick up on.
Well, let me pick up on it because I live in a very blue neighborhood in Austin. And my brothers are blue. I really didn't know any Republicans, at least not to talk to. And so being in Braver Angels and being in No Labels and there are other organizations as well, it's really enabled me to begin to get to know and hear from all shades of red.
Roger, can you take that? What's your experience?
Yeah, as far as people I know, you know, I kind of feel like that there is truth there. A lot of folks that lean red are also kind of in positions throughout society where we have no other option but to be around others that are different than us. But I think we have made it very difficult for people to reach across with an olive branch and say, hey, you know, I'm Dorsey, I'm blue. Tell me how you came to be, you know, really into your, you know, firearms or whatever it is. You know what I mean? We don't make it easy. We really don't make it easy.
Dorsey, you mentioned about your concern over being triggered by people who don't agree with you. Have you had any of that in Braver Angels? Have either of you ever triggered each other?
Not yet. We haven't interacted that much. Well, you'll find out when we meet after the election. We'll keep going.
Okay. Well, we look forward to it. What do you think will be achieved by the Trustworthy Elections Initiative?
You know, I think there's the selfish part first. It's really helping me grow, like Dorsey was talking earlier, to get out there and be around people that we may or may not think we have anything in common, but actually we do. And there's a lot more that we probably agree on. We just don't know what we don't know yet. And so, one, I want to make more friends and it's important to expand your worldview, to grow as a human, and get me out of the silo. And like Dorsey said, get off the keyboard, get off of social media. But really, I think it's just showing people, even though this may or may not work, we're going to go the distance and we're not stopping. Be a brick in the bridge that builds that bridge to cross the divide. That's what we are. We're all individual bricks. And so we've got to put ourselves to use. We have to put legs on our faith. We have to put action to our words, and we've got to go do it.
I love what Roger said about we're all individual bricks. I love that image. Thank you. That's just felt so good. And so my hope, Richard, is that at least some of the voters will notice us, be curious, come over and talk. My hope is that a number of different people will take our card, and some of them at least will attend that Zoom that night. My hope is that we get a little more publicity about what we're doing that will kind of attract certain people. That's my hope. My fear is we just sit there and nothing, you know, nobody wants our card or sees us, you know, there's always that. But I was going to make a suggestion, Richard, if I may. Why don't you get together with us after Election Day or somebody, so one pair from Braver Angels doing this, it doesn't have to be us, and kind of see, or maybe a group, kind of see, what happened? What were the people's reactions?
This may shock you, Dorsey, but I was just about to say, can we check back with you after Election Day?
Yes.
Can we do this like on the Wednesday after Election Day?
I'd love
and
it.
Turn around a quick podcast.
Oh, God.
And see
yes.
how it went.
That'd be terrific.
Yeah. Yeah. Absolutely.
Oh, I'm delighted I found Roger because he just full of energy and, you know, takes initiative, and he's out there, and I'm a scaredy cat, and it's just going to be great.
Dorsey and Roger, thank you very much for joining us on How Do We Fix It?
Oh, you bet. Thank you, Richard. This was great.
Yeah. Thanks, Richard. Great to be with you and Dorsey.
Roger Haynes and Dorsey Cartwright. We hope to interview at least one more pair between now and Election Day, Braver Angels Reds and Blues sitting together outside polling places across America. If you'd like to be part of it, grab a friend from across the political aisle or a relative that you may always fight with at Thanksgiving and head down the street to the polls to share this message of hope. You can find more details at our show page and website, howdowefixit.me. We'll have a link to braverangels.org. I'm Richard Davies. Our sound designer and producer is Miranda Schaefer. All our How Do We Fix It podcasts are productions of daviescontent.com. Thanks for listening.
This podcast is part of the Democracy Group.